The only place that we can really have peace is in the presence of God. A man was removed from the presence of God with the fall, when Adam was thrown out of paradise. And ever since, man has been out of the presence of God. But God sent Jesus to come and take away the disposition of sin, because sin separates us from God. Sin separated Adam from God, and sin separates us from God. The wages of sin is death. The only way that you can get rid of sin is with the shedding of blood. And Jesus died. He is the Son of God, and God sent him, provided a body for him to come and live and walk this earth as a sinless person. He was God and he is God, and he died for sinners to atone for our sin, that if we believe in Christ and we obey him, he takes away our sin. Sin separates us from God and causes anxiety. So we need to get rid of sin. You must have heard the expression that a person sleeps like a baby. Why is that? A baby has no sin. He is born into a sinful world and he has a sinful nature, but he hasn't committed sin yet. So what causes the anxiety and the pain and the anguish? It is sin. For a little baby that grows up, either his own sin causes him anxiety when he does wrong, or the sin of others, people that live sinfully and treat him badly because of their sinful nature. And so sin finds his way into our lives and causes anxiety and fear and eventually death. We were made as a temple of the Holy Spirit, for the Spirit of God to come and dwell in us. So when we are born, we're born with our own spirit. And God puts a conscience into us. But we must, by decision, we must invite the Spirit of Christ into us. We must accept Jesus Christ and ask him to come and live in us, so that he can fill that void that God has made. God has made us as a vessel for his Spirit to dwell in. Now we have the choice, whatever we want to allow into this physical body. We have our own spirit, and there are demonic spirits, and there's the Spirit of God. But we choose whom we allow into our body. If we do sinful things, then we allow sin into our lives. We also allow these sinful habits to take a hold of us, and it becomes a habit. And many of them are demons, which start to compel us and cause us to do things that we don't want to do. A habit is, on the one hand, it is a physical habit that I form, but on the other hand, when a demon comes with it, then it starts compelling me, and I do it not because I want to do it or I decide to do it anymore, but this thing has got a hold of me and I cannot help it. That's the way the demons come into us. Demons are also come into us through our parents and through other ways, but the main avenue that demons come into us, and oppression and fear, anxiety, is through a lot of the things that we do. Obviously, there are many children that have been abused, that grew up under abusive conditions, that had fear caused to them and caused fear in their lives. And the way to get rid of that, the only way, is to get Jesus into your life, because Jesus came to deliver us from fear and from oppression, and to restore our relationship with God so that we can live in perfect peace, although we live in a physical body. Now, if we want the peace of God to come into us, we must, by decision, decide to get rid of those things that separate us from God. And those things are sin, sinfulness. So, if I want the peace of God, I must ask Jesus to come into my life, but I must reject sin, because that sin separates me from God. And if I do not reject sin, then Jesus will not come into my life. So I need to repent of my sin. Repent means to turn my back on the sin, to reject it, and to decide never to do it again. The only way that I can get my conscience cleared of the things that I've done wrong, in other words, have my sins forgiven, is through the blood of Jesus. Through asking forgiveness from Jesus Christ, and ask Him, Lord, please forgive me. Come into my life and make me new. And He will come in and He will make me new. But then, to stay clean, I must obey Jesus Christ and follow Him. Get into a relationship with Him. Now, when I invite Jesus into my life, He comes in and He lives in me by His Spirit. His Spirit comes and lives in my spirit. So, the Spirit of God comes into this empty vessel, which can be filled with my spirit, demonic spirits, or the Spirit of God, by my choice. But when I invite Jesus in, He will deliver me from demonic spirits if I ask Him to deliver me. Many people are demon oppressed because they've allowed these spirits into them. Now, when we invite Jesus in and we ask Him to deliver us, He will deliver us from these spirits. But we must get rid of the bad habits and the bad things that we did that caused these things to come into us. And the only one who can help us with that is Jesus Himself, by His Spirit who lives in us. And then we must ask, we must say, Lord, we must pray, we must ask Him, we must say, Lord, please show me what is there in my life that separates me from the peace of God. Whatever it be, sin or a habit or something that I'm doing or something that I've got in my house. What displeases God? And if I ask Jesus that, He will immediately bring it to my mind so that I know what is causing me to be in fear and in anguish. When that thing comes to my mind, I must get rid of that specific thing. I must ask Jesus to show me what it is, and as soon as He shows me, I must obey and I must get rid of it. Now, there are many things that we cannot get rid of. Maybe you are in an abusive relationship, and it's not so easy to get rid of an abusive partner who causes you fear and anxiety. But it is then that we ask the Spirit of God living in us and say, Lord, please help me with this. And how do I deal with it? It's written in James 1 verse 5. He says, if anyone needs wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives to all men freely, and it will be given him. So if we have the Spirit of Christ living inside of us, we ask God about our problems, and He will give us wisdom how to deal with those problems. The only one who can help us is Jesus Christ. And we must get into that relationship with Christ where we can ask Him and He will bring it to our mind. God made us. He knows how to communicate with us, but we must ask Him. The only way that we will stay free of sin and then be able to enter the kingdom of heaven is through a relationship with Jesus Christ where we obey Him. And He will guide us into all truth. So we must ask Jesus to put more and more of His Spirit into us. And the more we respond, the more He will speak to us. But we must speak to Him. We must make ourselves available to Him and ask Him. If we ask Him, then He will reveal Himself to us. We just cry out. We say, Lord, please help me. And He is ready to help you because He made us. We must call on the name of the Lord Jesus and we shall be saved. And we must live in obedience to Him. There are many Christians also who believe in Jesus Christ, but they do not obey the Spirit of God that lives inside of them, and they never get free. They haven't changed their habits, and therefore they're living in fear and anxiety because they do not obey the Holy Spirit of God inside of them, who tells them what to do. So if we're in anxiety, we must call out to God and say, Lord, please help me. And He loves us. He wants to set us free. That is why Jesus came to this world, is to set us free from sin and from anxiety also. He's the only one who can help us. Jesus bless you.